Hey everyone! In this video, I'm going to explain the resume and the rollback directives in detail and touch upon filtering of errors as well as nesting of error handler routes. The scenario shown here contains the same modules as the ones in the last two videos that cover the break directive and the commit and ignore directives respectively. However, the error handler route that is added to the Dropbox Create a Folder module is different. It contains a router with two routes, the first containing the resume directive, and the second containing an email module followed by the rollback directive, as well as containing another error handler route with the rollback directive. Let me break down the scenario for you. It begins with the Google Sheet Watch a Worksheet module. It's followed by a set variable module that creates the variable folder name and stores the value of the row order element. This variable is then mapped to the folder name field in the Dropbox Create a Folder module. Now, let's look at the error handler route. Instead of adding a directive or a module, I've added a router to filter error types and handle them differently. Let me explain both the routes in detail. On the first route, I have a filter with a condition so that only a data error is processed. A data error takes place if a folder with the same name already exists on Dropbox, and therefore you need to make sure that you don't have this setting checked under Advanced Settings in the Dropbox module that renames the new folder if a folder with the same name exists. The objective is to upload a file in an existing folder, instead of creating a new folder, renaming it, and uploading it there. The filter is followed by the resume directive where the item folder name is mapped. Let's simulate this error. And here you go. When the Dropbox Create a Folder module encounters a data error, the resume directive supplies a substitute value for the folder path to the upload a file module, which is executed as if no error takes place. A new folder is not created since a folder with the same name existed, and the file is uploaded to that existing folder. Moving on to the second route, first, let's look at the filter, all other errors. It does not contain any condition, but the default route option is checked, which means that this route is used only if a data bundle cannot continue on any other route. Much like an if-else condition, where if a bundle matches a condition, in this case, the error being a data error, then it takes the first route, else take the second route. Also, the default route is distinguished with a different arrow symbol inside a router. Now, it's essential to mark the second route as the default route in this case for the first route to work. That's because the resume directive resumes the execution from the Create a Folder module, and in the absence of a default route, the second route will also get executed and stop the scenario due to this rollback directive, diminishing the purpose of the resume directive altogether. Let me show you what I mean. I'll uncheck the default route option and run the scenario again. As you can see, the bundle passed through both the routes, but the upload a file module wasn't processed since the rollback directive on the second route stopped the scenario execution immediately. Now let me explain the rollback directive in detail. To do that, I need to simulate an error besides the data error for the bundle to take the second route, which is my default route for all other error types. So I will go to the set variable module and simply remove the variable value and run the scenario. In the Dropbox Create a Folder module, a bundle validation error took place due to the missing value of the required parameter, folder name. Thus, the second route was taken. The send an email module was processed and the rollback directive stopped the scenario execution.
The rollback directive also starts a rollback phase on all modules in an attempt to revert each of them back to its initial state.
However, some modules do not support rollback and the data processed by those modules cannot be reverted. Case in point, the send an email module right here. Once the email is sent, it cannot be undone. All Integromat modules marked with the asset tag support transactionality and are reverted back to their initial state when another module encounters an error. Also, when using the rollback directive, it's important to keep in mind that barring a few other error types, the scenario is deactivated after the number of consecutive errors specified under scenario settings. Now, you might have noticed that there's another error handler route with the rollback directive added to the email module. This is to ensure that if the email module also encounters an error, the rollback directive on its error handler route starts a rollback phase on all the modules. I will just remove the recipient email address from here and run the scenario to mimic this error. Okay. As you can see, the email module encountered a runtime error, and the rollback directive on its error handler route was processed. This is also known as nesting of error handler routes, as this module is part of an existing error handler route due to the Dropbox Create a Folder module.
That concludes the resume and rollback directives. Here's a quick recap of the differences between the two. Resume specifies a substitute output and supplies it to the module that encounters an error, and processes the subsequent modules as if no error took place. It marks the scenario execution status as success. Rollback stops the scenario execution immediately and starts a rollback phase on all modules in an attempt to revert each of them back to its initial state. It marks the scenario execution status as error. Additionally, you must keep in mind the following. A scenario is deactivated after the number of consecutive errors specified under scenario settings. All Integromat modules marked with the ACID tag support transactionality and are reverted back to their initial state when another module encounters an error. A bundle takes a router's default route only if it cannot continue on any other route.
That brings us to the end of the error handling lesson. You should now be able to handle any error that interferes with the smooth functioning of your scenarios. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next lesson.